Well, I had some questions for the witness, Mr. Burke, but he has absconded. So I'm going to use my 5 minutes, but not to ask questions. It is interesting, though, to have heard Mr. Goldman refuse to answer a question about the investigation, yet he comes in here, and the very reason that he wants to see the president for the first time any president's ever been removed from office, why he's been obstructing. He didn't answer our questions. So perhaps if we're going to apply his sense of justice to him, it would be time to have him removed from his position. But that's only if we apply his own standards. And as Chris Plant said, if it weren't for double standards, some of these folks wouldn't have standards at all. But we were told also at the beginning that we would hear lawyers present evidence. Lawyers are going to come in here. Now, what normally happens, and I've been in some kangaroo hearings in courts, not my own when I was there, but I have been mistreated in hearings before, but I have never seen anything like this where we don't allow the fact witnesses to come in here. We have the lawyers come in and tell us what we're supposed to know about those witnesses and about their testimony and about their impression and what the law is. This is outrageous. My friend Jim Sensenbrenner said in 41 years, he's never seen anything like what we have going on here to try to oust a sitting president. And it's also outrageous to hear people say, well, this man thought he was a king because he said he could do anything he wanted, when they know that that statement was in the context of whether or not he could fire Mueller. And of course he could fire Mueller. He could fire or not fire Mueller. He could appoint a special prosecutor to invest Mueller and Weissman. I think he should have. But that's his prerogative, and he could have done anything about that he wanted. To take that out of context, he thinks he's a king. Let me tell you what a king is. A king is someone who says over 20 times, I can't do that. Congress has to change the law on immigration. And then he decides, you know what? I got a pen. I got a phone. I'll do whatever I want. And by golly, he does. He makes new law with a pen and a phone. Now, that is more like a monarchy, not somebody saying they can fire a special prosecutor if they want to. And regarding treason, the Constitution itself says you got to have two witnesses. And that's not hearsay witnesses, none of this stuff that wouldn't be admissible in any decent court. No, that's two direct evidence witnesses that can come in and positively identify themselves, not something they overheard or something, but actually be witnesses to treason. And yet this group comes in here, they toss treason out in a report like it's no big deal. We can bring in a bunch of hearsay witnesses, and then we'll have the lawyers testify and then throw a president out of office. This is so absurd. It's so absurd. Now, we have a witness come in, and we're told he's going to be a witness. That's why he doesn't have to follow under the rules of decorum. And then, I've never seen this. He gets to come up and grill his opposing adversary witness. I feel like, to be fair, if we were going to make this thing fair, Mr. Castor would be able to come up and grill Mr. Burke. But this isn't about being fair. It's not about due process. This is about a kangaroo system. And let me tell you, those that think you've done something special here, you have set the bar so low, I'm afraid it's irreparable. I mean, just think, we've had people already mention, you know, the next president, Joe Biden, we're told, you know, gee, he may be the next president. Well, we've already got the forms. All we have to do is eliminate Donald Trump's name and put Joe Biden's name in there because he's on video, he and his son. He basically has admitted to the crime that's being hoisted on the president improperly. So I'm scared for my country because I've never seen anything like this. This is supposed to be the Congress. I came up here from a court where we had order and we had rules, and I've seen nothing of the kind in here today. And it's outrageous that we're trying to remove a president with a kangaroo court like this. I yield back.
Chairman, Chairman, if I could just clarify, treason is not in our report. I just want
to... The gentleman yielded back.
Yeah, and it is mentioned in the report we got. Thank you very much.
The gentleman yielded back. Mr. Johnson.